10 Habits That Destroy You Mentally. We all have daily routines and habits that complete our day. For some, it is as simple as drinking coffee or tea in the morning, while for others, it can be as complicated as completing one set of exercises. These habits aren't just things we do out of a routine, they also have effects on us. Little by little, they either lead our bodies into a better or worse state. In today's Bright Light video, we will talk about the 10 habits that destroy you mentally. But before we get started, if you are new here, please do not forget to subscribe to our channel so that you can join a community where learning about psychology is welcomed and encouraged. You can also click the notification bell so that we can notify you whenever we post new videos online. Now that we got that covered, let's get straight to the video. Number 1. Perfectionism. It is a good thing that you aim for excellence and high-quality performance. This can help you reach a lot of goals and milestones in school, career, or life in general. You actually increase your chances of living a successful life if you aim to always do things in an excellent way. However, wanting to do things perfectly or falling into the hands of perfectionism can actually cause you quite the opposite. There are two types of perfectionism, positive and negative. Positive perfectionism encourages you to strive for excellence since you will never settle for anything less than your very best work. Setting reasonable objectives, letting go of failures, viewing mistakes as chances for improvement, controlling worry and tension within healthy limits, and taking pleasure in both the process and the result are all traits of positive perfectionism. On the other hand, setting impossible expectations, being unsatisfied with anything less than perfection, obsessing over failure or rejection, and viewing mistakes as proof of unworthiness are all traits of negative perfection. Number 2. Poor posture. Did you know that simply changing the way you sit and stand can improve your mental health? According to a study published in the Journal of Behavior Therapy and Experimental Psychiatry, the simple act of sitting up straight can help you reduce symptoms of depression. If you practice good posture, it also improves your overall self-esteem and mood. Aside from that, it can also help you have a more positive attitude, reduce fatigue, and decrease self-focus in those with mild to moderate depression. Number 3. Guilt. Although packaged in a very negative way, guilt actually plays an important role in society. It causes a person to feel bad about the wrong things they have done. This results in them not wanting to do that again. However, too much guilt or guilt even in the wrong places can affect your mental health big time. For example, this bad habit of guilt is usually planted when we are just kids, when some parents would scold children and force them to eat everything on their plate because a lot of kids are starving. Out of the fear and guilt for the starving kids, the child now has to act a certain way. This extends to doing something or accomplishing a task out of the fear or guilt of not making your family proud. Habits of guilt include exaggerating issues, attributing blame for issues that you had little or nothing to do with, viewing little transgressions as terrible behavior on your part, and refusing to grant yourself forgiveness. If you live in constant fear and guilt, you are preventing yourself from truly reaching your full potential. Number 4. Lack of exercise. You may deny it at first, but it's true that a sedentary lifestyle affects not only your physical health, but also your mental health. Exercise is described as nature's natural mood lifter by Psych Central. By inhibiting immune system chemicals that exacerbate sadness, boosting body temperature to have a soothing impact, and releasing endorphins and other feel-good chemicals, regular exercise may help those with depression. Regular exercise can also boost your self-esteem, divert your attention from worries, enhance social interactions, and help you deal with stress in a healthy way. Bad exercise habits that might harm your mental health include exercising infrequently or not at all, working out until you're exhausted, using poor technique, and sticking to only one type of exercise. Number 5. Failure mindset. Our brain has a unique way of protecting us and making sure we are doing well. Sometimes these are the negative or anxious thoughts that we have. A normal amount of them actually does nothing to your mental health. However, if you have the habit of entertaining all of them and letting them grow in your mind, you might develop the failure mindset. This does not only cause you to feel bad about yourself or your life, but also stops you from doing things out of the fear of failing. One of the behaviors of a failure mindset is listening to the voice inside of you that tells you you can't do it, you have no choice, or you should quit before people find out you're a fraud. Failure-related thoughts and sentiments seriously impair mental health and increase anxiety and sadness. Negative ideas prevent you from setting goals, minimize the importance of your innate abilities, and amplify your errors. Number 6. Overuse of social media. Two of the most common issues teenagers face now are the problems with anxiety and low self-esteem. According to the Child Mind Institute, this can be traced back to the overuse of social media, and this does not affect teenagers alone, but also adults. The usage of several social media sites is also associated with a higher risk of anxiety and depression, according to a recent study that was published in Psychiatric News. According to a recent poll of 1,500 adult Facebook and Twitter users, 62% of respondents said they felt insufficient and 60% said they were jealous of other social media users. 30% claimed that utilizing just these two social media platforms made them feel lonely. Number 7. Overuse of a smartphone. It's really satisfying to use a smartphone. There are several apps, messaging services, and websites that make people feel good. However, regular smartphone use makes you frequently check your device out of fear of missing anything. Some mental health practitioners fear that excessive smartphone use can lead to a type of addiction in which people check their smartphones compulsively for notifications and updates. A recent study published in the Journal of Affective Disorders suggests that compulsive or excessive smartphone use may exacerbate the signs and symptoms of depression, anxiety, chronic stress, and/or low self-esteem. Negative impacts of excessive smartphone use can be amplified by a lack of encouraging notifications, a constant stream of depressing news stories, and arguments on social media. Number 8. Regret. Just like guilt, regret is another emotion that plays an important role in society. When we regret not doing something, we look for ways not to miss it the second time around. However, too much regret can be detrimental to your mental health too. In a study cited by Psychology Today, they found out that people who live in cultures that can control their life choices have felt more regret than those whose life seems to be arranged. It can be related to the many choices they did not make. It's okay to feel regret from time to time, but when it becomes a habit, it can lead to depression, anxiety, sleep problems, and difficulty concentrating. It can even go as bad as affecting your physical health. Number 9. Codependency. Your ability to have a healthy, mutually rewarding relationship is hampered by the codependency habit. According to Mental Health America, codependency is a taught trait that is passed down through families. As a result, you might have picked up your parents' penchant for appeasing others. Codependency was first used by psychologists to refer to partners in chemical dependence, but it is now frequently used to refer to any one-sided relationship. Include placing oneself last to take care of another and prioritizing someone else's wants before your own. Codependency steals your identity and puts your health, welfare, and security in peril. Number 10. Poor sleep. Whenever you sleep, a lot of physical and biological processes also begin. This is why skipping a few hours of it can feel very tiring or weird. You are letting yourself recover and rest by sleeping at night. If having poor and irregular sleeping patterns becomes your habit, you are more at risk of feeling groggy, grumpy, and out of focus, and even a bad mental health. Getting too little or insufficient sleep, late-day caffeine consumption, stressful activities just before bed, and utilizing electronics right before bed are all examples of poor sleep patterns. According to research, those who have mental health issues frequently have trouble sleeping. According to the Sleep Health Foundation, 60 to 90% of depressed people also suffer from sleeplessness. According to the National Alliance on Mental Illness, sadness, anxiety, or psychological stress are involved in more than half of all episodes of insomnia. According to the Harvard Mental Health Letter published by Harvard Medical School, experts now believe that getting enough sleep can cause mental health issues, and that addressing the sleep condition can help ease mental health symptoms. That ends our video for today. We hope you have learned a thing or two. If you did, please like this video and leave a comment on the comments section below. We would love to hear your thoughts, suggestions, and reactions. If you want similar videos, do not forget to subscribe to us and click the notification bell so you can get notified whenever we post new videos. Until next time, bye.